Lightning strikes in a flash, brilliant and gone in less than a second. But the thunder, it cracks and then it rumbles on and on, sometimes for several seconds. Have you ever wondered why? The answer lies in the sheer size of the lightning bolts, which are essentially superheated channels of air carrying immense electrical current. This extreme heat causes the brilliant blue-white light. As these channels explosively expand into cooler air, a powerful pressure pulse is created, generating the sound we hear as thunder. Importantly, lightning bolts can extend for several kilometers, with each point along the channel producing its own light and sound nearly simultaneously. Now, since light travels incredibly fast, we see the entire lightning flash almost instantly. Sound, on the other hand, moves like a leisurely snail in comparison, just about 343 meters per second in air. As a result, sound from different parts of the long lightning channel reach us at different times. We first hear the thunder from the nearest part of the lightning channel, followed by sounds from increasingly distant points. This delay in sound arrival from different parts of the lightning channel results in the prolonged rumbling of thunder, which can last for several seconds depending on the length of the lightning strike and how far away it is from us. The distance thunder travels before reaching us not only stretches it in time, but also alters its sound due to absorption of sound waves by air. High-pitched or high-frequency sound waves are more strongly absorbed by air than low-frequency waves. Consequently, if thunder travels a long distance, most of the high-frequency sounds are absorbed by the atmosphere, leaving behind a predominant low-pitched growl. Conversely, if lightning strikes nearby, we can hear both the high and low-pitched sounds, resulting in the sharp cracking sound of thunder. In a nutshell, slow speed of sound compared to light and sheer lengths of lightning bolts make thunder to appear stretched out over several seconds, while lightning is gone in a flash. So, next time you are caught in a thunderstorm, listen carefully to the rolling thunder. It's not just a rumble. It's the story of two different types of waves propagating vastly differently in air. And of course, please don't forget to rush to safety if you hear thunder. It's a warning that you are within striking distance of lightning.